आपने दो दो फ्रेंड्स एक साथ भेज दिए है ना?
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, should we start the session?
Just 2 minutes. The participants are joining.
Charvi, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, I've sent another PPT also. There'll be two today. Ek pehle ki and the second one too. I just sent you on WhatsApp, I think, if it's possible. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, otherwise all the participants are already mute, I think.
Yes, ma'am.
But they can hear, but they can hear.
Yes, you can start.
You received the second PPT also?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you can start the first one.
Okay.
So today's session, good afternoon to all the participants who are there for this art therapy workshop today. So we are going to do some art therapy exercises as we had planned for today's session. So there'll be various affirmation exercises in art therapy and positive affirmations will be there. At the same time, how you use visualization boards and art journaling for art therapy, all that would be for today's session. So, Charubi is starting that. The slides will be coming up. And I hope all the participants are ready. We have 44 today who have logged in, I believe, because that's what it shows. No, 52 who have logged in. So I believe you all are ready for the art therapy exercise session of today.
I hope all of you can see my screen.
It is clear and visible to me. It looks very clear. Yeah, they're saying yes. So getting response. So the first slide is about how to visualize, because the first question that comes to your mind is, yes, we are doing art therapy. So what is visualization? What are art therapy exercises? Because obviously yesterday was an introduction of art therapy. Today the session deals with the various ways in, and yesterday we talked about the different ways art therapy can be done. So today we're talking about visualization and affirmation exercises. So first and foremost thing is how to visualize. So you have to first step in this is that you have to find a quiet place and a comfortable place, and you can sit. It could be it could be a spot in your house where you find, you know, a peaceful spot in your house where you can sit and visualize. Or perhaps you can go out into the open in your lawn and sit under a tree, or perhaps on your swing, or any favorite place. It could even be your office. There is no chaos of family and people moving around. So it could even be your office where you don't have much of disturbance. And anywhere which is peaceful, so you have to go to sit in a peaceful place. It could be just a corner in your house. You don't have to go about finding places too. And second thing is that you have to clear your mind of all things that have cluttered, because every day we go through so many conversations from your spouse, from your children, from your parents, from the workers in your place. So you have too many things on your mind from everywhere. So you just need to clear your mind and focus on what you're thinking. So you close your eyes, you relax, and you think of your goals, your aims, what you want in your life. So that is how visualization takes place. And then you slowly, as you close your eyes, you have to take a few deep breaths. So first you relax yourself, and then you continue to focus on your breathing. So you're just focusing on your breathing, you're relaxing your mind, you're not thinking of other things, and you count down from 20, and each time you keep doing this until you feel that your mind has relaxed and all the stress, the tension, everything has gone away. All the thoughts that were cluttering your mind have slowly vanished. You can do it as I'm saying also, that you can close your eyes and you can feel yourself, because at this moment you're focusing on this meeting. So you can do this while we are doing this. And you just relax during the process. And then the third thing is you have to imagine, can you bring the slide a little up at the goals? Then you imagine your goals. You have to visualize all the details of the final day of your project. Visualize as many details as you can, the sight, the sounds, and everything. So that is important. You can go back to slide one. Yeah. So the people who are present, what do you hear, the sights, the sounds, everything about your goal. For example, you are thinking that I have won this particular award or got this particular job, so then I came and when I come back home, how does it feel that the parents are coming in and congratulating, and you imagine that you're sitting in that office as where you wanted that job, and you imagine that what you can hear people talking and discussing. So you can slowly visualize whatever goal you want. To win a beauty pageant, it's different for every person. A person might want to win a beauty pageant. A person might be thinking that I want to imagine that day. My goal is that I get this particular job, I reach to this position, and you imagine yourself in that position, in that office, in that place. I want to get a job in Google headquarters, and you know, this particular place. So, you know, whatever is your goal in life, you have to define that for yourself. And then you visualize that and you keep doing that. So that kind of, you know, helps in manifesting your goals and it helps in reaching you there. Because first thing is that you have to define what you want in life. Now the second slide. Now the second slide is about the vision board cards. So it's not just that. One exercise is this, that you visualize in this way. Second thing could be that you can create your own vision boards. You know, you have so many people coming up with so many things and they say you can't do this or you are not good at this or maybe I'm sure that you are not capable of this. You keep hearing all that negative chit-chatter about you. I'm sure teenagers also face that. I don't think you are capable to be a doctor. I don't think you can ever make it and do this. So people always, sometimes they might just discourage you and they might just demotivate you in ways which actually makes you feel in a negative, you get develop negative feelings. But then it's up to you. You have to know your focus is where. So for that, you as I have seen in families, even parents at times, they demoralize their children. It could be grandparents. You are not good at, you're just sitting and you keep wasting your time. You don't know how to, rather than positively motivating your children, or they keep on comparing them or demotivating them in this way. So this is not the way to do it. And that is why teenagers face a lot of trouble, because instead of positively motivating them, telling them ways how to tackle it and come up, because the moment you start motivating somebody, then a person can actually achieve the impossible. But the moment you start demotivating anybody, whether it's an adult or a teenager, they might just, you know, have those negative feelings and they will be doubtful about it. So how do you overcome it? Through art therapy. You create your vision boards. You create those for yourself. Because sometimes we cannot change the people around us. The influences can come from anyone and they might just give you some negative talk and that might affect you for a lot. So you can just cut yourself out. You need to have that visualization techniques in your mind. How to cut yourself away from all those things. Because all of us go through this. At some point or the other. It's not just teenagers. Everybody faces these kind of challenges in their lives, where some people really do not have faith in your abilities, where they feel that you are good for nothing and that you cannot end up, you know, achieving anything. So that is not the case. Like if you have put certain targets and goals in your life, certainly you will reach somewhere. So you have to work on it. All that negative talk and all that things of letting you down should not overwhelm you. So that is where art therapy helps. It's not a magic potion that it will just clear you out and all of a sudden you will start dancing and you'll be, you know, on top of the world. It's nothing like that. Art therapy never does that. Neither does it guarantee that you don't take any medications for anxiety or depression. But it is a coping skill if it is used in the right fashion. It will certainly help you overcome those negative feelings if it is used in the right way. So vision boards, visualization is for that. So these are cards that are there. So if I'm committed, there is always a way. All that negative talk, all the demoralization is at one side, and you can create your own way of more, you know, pushing yourself up. So each morning we are born again. What we do today, we is what matters most. So these are the kind of vision board cards that you can, you know, make for yourself. Because life changes at every single moment. So you cannot assume that you're stuck and you will not move out of that particular problem. So all these affirmations are very important. You can move to the next slide now. So the affirmations, as you say, are positive, give you some positive vibes, they give you positive feelings inside you and help you come out of all the, the negativity that is around you, because you cannot control that. The thing is that the controlling power is with you. only as much as you can just keep yourself, your sanity intact by doing things which make you happy. Making art makes you happy. Creating a vision board makes you happy that these are my goals in life. And this is how, so it gives you a push. So art therapy is not a magic pill. So nobody is telling you that. Neither am I telling you, neither is Search Alive telling you. It's not a magic pill. We are just telling you ways of coping, the coping mechanisms to deal with anxiety and all these problems. So daily affirmation is an art journal where you can put down your things. Like I have a, you know, anything good about yourself. People body shame you, you put good things about yourself. What are the positive things about your looks? So you can put that. So if people say you can't do things on time, you put that down, that I will get everything done on time. I'm grateful for my house, because you have to have a gratitude journal. Gratitude journaling is very important. And I deserve and receive a good amount of money every day. So that's a financial affirmation. I'm not perfect, and that is okay. So because life is imperfect, nobody's got anything perfect. Our fingers are all not perfect, they're all different sizes. Just look at this. So that means that God has somewhere made us, nature has given us these things, that nothing will be perfect. Everything will be the way it is. And so you should accept that. And I'm not perfect, and that is okay. So I also have flaws. I also have positive attributes. So, and then my thoughts matter. What is going in my head, that matters. I'm grateful. I love my body. I love my figure. I love, people say, oh my God, she's, you know, they body shame you that, oh my God, she's put on so much weight and she looks so body and she looks this and that. And they compare you with some XYZ female who's slim. And then that female is also body shamed because she is too thin and she doesn't have the right curves. So, no, nothing is perfect in life. Everybody gets, you know, somewhere something is lacking in everyone. So you need to put those affirmations for yourself on a affirmation chart and create a journal like this. This is called an art journal. So can we go to the next slide? So while will you manifest, when you think about things and you have all this chaotic state of mind and people are constantly giving you all the bullcrap possible and they're giving you all those negative vibes. So what you do is you have to stay positive in the first place. How do you do that? So you say things, you manifest things. How do you do them? You think about them as if they're already done. You've achieved those goals. And do not spend time thinking about anything opposite to what you want. Meditate on what you want. You know, I'll just give you an example of Shah Rukh Khan. He was rejected so many times. He was too short. He never had very good features. And then in an interview on so many times on media, he said that then perhaps he would have become a superstar. He's the one of the richest superstars we have here, and a very successful one. So become a super. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, can you hear? Can hear you.
Okay.
Because there is a question. There is one question. Yeah. One participant is asking, what we can do if we are not able to make positive affirmations at that moment.
See, nobody is born doing affirmations. It is an exercise. Like when you want to reduce your, you know, fat around your arms, you keep exercising like 20 times, you do this exercise, you do this exercise, and then gradually it becomes the same thing is with your mind. You don't not born with any kind of affirmations in your brain, so you need to put down on paper, you need to repeat it to yourself, and that's how that's what I'm telling you, talking to you about, that you need to create visualization boards, you need to make art journaling a habit in your life. Even adults like me do that. So I openly talk about it, and it's not something that to be, you know, I don't feel embarrassed of talking about it, because that's the way I also deal. In fact, that's the way I recommend teenagers also and all the adults who, first thing is you need to put down your thoughts and your affirmations on paper. And you need to sit, and that's what I was talking about, how to sit. And there were three steps that I came to. So you have to think about that and you go about it. You'll be able to do it, not on the first day maybe. Like once you start doing Surya Namaskar, maybe the first day you're not able to do it, because it's a difficult set of exercise. It's a difficult exercise. So, but you still do Surya Namaskar because you want to reduce weight and you want to become toned and trimmed. So how do you do it? First day, your body aches. You feel very uncomfortable doing it. You feel, what the hell is this? Because you're not accustomed to pushing your body doing it. So the same with thing is with your mind. You have to make your mind believe things, and you have to keep repeating it to yourself and meditate on what you want. So you start imagining, and visualization is that only. So there are so many actors, like Jim Carrey once said it in his interview, and that interview is there all over. You can log on to your Google accounts and just go and check. He just said that he was rejected so many times, but he kept on rehearsing, kept on enacting, and kept on doing all these things. And eventually he did become a good comedian, and he did bag good roles in Hollywood movies. He was nobody. He didn't have anybody backing him up. So, but then neither was he very extremely good looking. But then he eventually became what he became. So that's how you do it. You have to have the faith in yourself. You have to keep on working towards it. And in spite of people telling you that you are not worth it, you still have to, you know, keep working on it. Can you go to the next slide? And I hope the question is also answered for the person who asked. So then there are 10 steps to creating a vision board. During art therapy, we do various techniques. So the techniques used are creating vision board. So what? How do you do it? There are steps that are involved in it. So first you decide what you want to bring in your life and what you want to focus on in your life. What exactly is your goal? What do you want in your life? First, define those things, write them down. And then you can scribble, draw, just draw those things around and all that. Choose images that represent those things. So it's not that you can only draw, you can choose certain images and make a collage of things that you want. Choose images that represent those things, plus images that appeal to you. Cover your board with large background images. Layer on smaller images. Add words and phrases. So that's how you create a vision board. So you have those images, either you draw them, either you scribble or doodle them. Like you see Wimpy Kid, you've read those doodle diaries and dog diaries and all. So they children have doodled and made things and have their creativity in place, and people do that. And if you don't find that comfortable, you can just cut up pictures and, you know, paste them and create your own vision board with that, and put some words and phrases which motivate you positively, because there's enough of negativity in the world, so you need to push yourself ahead. Fill in and rearrange until it's appealing. Add any embellishments, whatever you like, you can put over there. It's up to you how you embellish and decorate your vision board. And then to make it interesting, to make it eye-catching, so you can just keep looking at it. And take a picture in case it shifts. Glue everything on, starting with the background and working out, and hang it where you see it every day. So then this art therapy vision boards that are there. So first step is that you decide on what you want, the goal, where you have to put your focus. Then choose the images, then cover it with a good background and put the words and positive affirmations over there. And you see it gradually coming because you are constantly affirming what you want in your life. Yes, the next slide. So my circle of control and what is not in your control. So you make a circle and put all the things that are in your control. And outside the circle, you write everything that's out of your control. So there's not much of art involved in it or any artistic skill involved in that. The only thing is you need the things that I can control is my effort, how much effort I can put in. What decisions I'm making, those are in my control. So I put that inside the circle. How I handle my feelings and my emotions, that is in my control. That I put inside the circle. Whether or not I follow the rule, that is inside my control. So that I put inside the circle. How I treat others, that is within my control. If I'm kind to people, even though they are unkind to me or rude to me or whatever. So that is in your control. How, what your reactions are, how you respond to people. How I take care of myself in spite of whatever's happening. Like in COVID-19, people have stopped socializing, going out because nothing's happened. But you still have to take care of yourself. So you have to take care of these things, my actions, my words, and things that are out of your control, what other people do, what other people say, what other people's choices are, things that have happened in the past, jo cheeze ho, you know, all those things that have happened and they are done with. So those things are not out of your control. So especially people, when they talk about you, that is certainly not in your control. And so you don't have to think much about it because you cannot stop all those things. So you can focus on what is in your control. And now we go to the next slide. 10 steps to protect your vibe. Like your vibe is very positive. You are very high in energy and you're very pepped up. All of a sudden somebody comes and, you know, tells you this and that and suddenly you get disturbed. How do you control your vibe? You have to let go of things you can't control. First thing is, people get very affected with, you know, people bad mouthing about them, people talking behind their back and gossiping and this, that. So you can't control that. It's a world where you live in, and people will have, there'll be five people talking positive and five will be talking negative. So you just let go of things that are not in your control and avoid comparing yourself to others. Keep your faith larger than your fears. This is like the big, most important thing. That whatever, for example, COVID-19, everybody is caught in security during this corona, times of corona. And there are so many fears. There's financial insecurity. There is children are worried about their admissions and to colleges, how they're going to go about their jobs. Nothing is certain. So you have to keep your faith in place. And that is a very important thing. It's a very, very important thing that you have to keep your faith in place. And don't be afraid to spend time alone. As in, like, you don't need too many people. Now, you can't meet people. You have your friends, you can't meet them. So you have to spend some time alone. So don't be afraid of spending time alone. Speak kindly to yourself and to others. Yes, you have got to be kind to yourself. You get negative, impacts from here and there, but you have to be kind to yourself. Otherwise, you'll be a nervous wreck. So you have to be kind to yourself as well as to others. Please yourself before trying to please others. Nobody is going to take care of you if you don't take care of your own self. So that is a very onus, or the onus is on you, that you have to first help yourself. Stay, like, you're taking the art therapy class, it is for your benefit. You are learning something new. some new skills. So it is for you. So you are learning how to control yourself, how to control your feelings, emotions, because these are testing, trying times. COVID-19 has impacted. Nobody can say it hasn't impacted me. It has impacted globally everyone. Children, se leke poor adults, like everybody has been affected by it. Nobody can say that they've not been affected. So you have to stay away from people who drain your energy. Basically, there are people who will know that there are certain good qualities and bad qualities, like everybody is blessed with good and the bad, but they somehow talk so much negative and they drain your energy. So they might be jealous of you, or maybe they compare themselves with you, or whatever they might be the reason. But sometimes some people really drain away your energy. And so just stay away from those kind of people. So these are the ways to protect your wives. You can go to the next slide. Now, how conflict resolution strategies, what are the different conflict resolution strategies that a person can use? First thing is you can breathe, get calm, centered before dealing with the conflict. What happens is, at home or at school or at office or in a society, anywhere you can face any kind of conflicts that are happening, and people sometimes they target you on purpose also. So you don't have to really lose your mind on it. So you can breathe, get calm and deal with the conflict. And second thing is, you have to take a moment or hours or even days to think about how you want to deal with the conflict. And remind yourself that conflict is normal. Most conflict is not an emergency, because everyone is having conflict. Somebody might be accusing you of something, and somebody might be accusing you falsely of something, and of this and that. So you cannot just lose your mind. So it's not an emergency, it's a normal thing. So remember that it's normal to feel certain emotions like anger, fear or sadness during a conflict. Express your feelings with words, not actions, unless your action is something kind. And you don't lose your mind and start behaving violent, or you start going nuts about it. You have to deal with it, deal with the situation. How do you have to deal? You have to keep your emotions under control. And if you choose to talk it over, use an I statement like "I felt." Avoid making accusations or blaming people. You cannot blame anybody for anything. See, there have been people who have demoralized the biggest of people and have spoken ill of all the big celebrities, whether it's a politician, whether it's anybody. They do get bad mouthing from the people who don't like them, who are jealous of them, or they're successful as them. So you don't have to blame anybody for those accusations. Just deal with it on your level. And you don't attack the problem. You have to attack the problem, not the person. Whenever problem comes and you say, it's because of this one, this happened. No, you have to focus on the problem and the solutions to the problem. The focus should never be blaming others. And you have to focus on attacking the problem and how it has to be dealt with. So focus on just one issue and one conflict. You cannot combine two, three. It will create further discord. And invite some people to share their point of view. Listen without interrupting. Brainstorm win-win solutions. Focus on what you can change and be open-minded. Compromise. Take responsibility. Compromise. This is very important. We are very egoistic people nowadays. And we think that we are right. Why should we compromise? Or we are this. Why should we compromise? No, it is not that you are the person who's the high and mighty and the other person has to compromise. You have to even compromise and be open-minded about what it is. And take responsibility for your part in the conflict. People just deny, they start it, all the matter. And then they just, they don't take responsibility for your part in the conflict. So you take the responsibility. Consider how others may be affected by your action. Just not yourself. Don't be selfish only to think it is going to affect how it is affecting me. It has hurt me, because I have seen people become victims. Oh, this happened and I'm the victim, I'm the victim. They play the victim card, but you don't realize in the process you have also been saying things or you have also done things that might have affected others. You have to apologize for that. Apologize if you have made a mistake and you have affected the other person, and learn from your mistakes and don't hurt other people as well. Because if there have been times that people say, I am the victim, I'm better, they are never the victim. I have mostly faced people who keep on saying, I'm the victim, they are never the victim, rather they victimize others. And they say that, so people harp too much about their problems. You have to see all these things and gauge what is, where things are wrong and who is to blame and who is not to blame in that. So you have to focus on what you can change, be open-minded, compromise, take responsibility, don't blame others, apologize, learn from your mistakes. And it's okay to disagree at times with the other person, because there are healthy disagreements. What are debates all about? The disagreement is there. So, you know, that's also okay. You can go to the next slide. So this is a part of school counseling, actually. Then there is something called a self-love. How do you practice self-love in art therapy? First, you write something to yourself. Because why are you taking art therapy? Because certainly something is disturbing your mind. Somewhere something has affected you. So then what has affected you? So you have to create a self-love journal for your mind, body and soul. So you write a love letter to yourself. List 10 things that you're grateful for. Buy yourself something which makes you happy, like flowers. Read a good book that you find interesting, a favorite novel, and create a vision board where you put your dreams together and ambitions together. And create for your body, you can pamper yourself for a manicure or pedicure or a walk. Perhaps you go for 30 minutes for a half. That's how you pamper yourself. And take a long, relaxing bubble bath in your tub, or relaxing yoga or a Zumba or whatever relaxes aerobics. Nourish your body with healthy home food. Healthy food is also important, so don't fill up yourself with junk. So that's how self-love is. It's not that you are being deprived. It's being, being privileged. If you can eat fruits, you can eat dry fruits, vegetables. These are healthy things. So you put your some healthy home-cooked food for yourself, and that's how you nourish your system. It's not starving your soul or your system. And for your soul, you have to create loving, positive affirmations for yourself. So there are enough people telling what is wrong with you. So you have to create your own positive, thing for yourself. Yes, don't draw on the screen, please, because you're spoiling the slide. Then go to the next one. You can go to the next one, Jaruvi. So these are kind of vision boards and vision quotes that you can put. Have hope, no fear, trust God, do not worry, take a deep breath. God is with you, love yourself, do good, pray often. So these are the kind of art therapy quotes that you can say, that you can put for affirming positive vibes into your life. And these are just a few. So which I've just, put on this. So. Trusting God is important. Having now one word prints like words like balance, grateful, unapologetic. Like people make you say sorry for every goddamn thing. People who are very dominating might not never accept their faults, and they ask you. So you have to be unapologetic to yourself. Grace, joy, focus, inspire, healthy, hope, strength, persistence, confidence. Simplify, simplicity, consistency, persistence. All these are very positive words. So these are one words. These are words which you can put down on your art journals. See, there is calligraphy. Yesterday somebody was asking me, can I practice calligraphy for art therapy? See, this is calligraphy. So you can take your calligraphy pens, which are available online on Amazon, and you can create these one word affirmations for yourself. And this is an exercise for that. This is an art therapy exercise for it. And now we go to the next slide. Okay, now that's over.
That was the last slide. The meeting is ending in 30 seconds. So I request everybody to rejoin with the same link you used right now.
And one more thing, I've put this affirmation. There's a vision board that I have created over here. You can see, I can't really go too far. Yeah. Some restrictions. So this is a